Welcome to all students. Today we discuss in design of transmission system there is types of clutches. In types of clutches there are two types, positive clutches and frictional clutches. There is positive clutches. These clutches are used when positive drive is required. The advantages of positive clutches is during engagement of the clutch, heat is not generated. These clutches do not slip during this operation, but there is some disadvantages of positive clutches. During engagement of clutch, shock, vibration and noise are generated. These clutches cannot be engaged at high speeds. So we discuss about friction clutches. Friction clutches, there are advantages. These clutches are easy to operate. Frequent engagement and disengagement of the plate is possible. These clutches can be engaged when driven shaft is rotating and driven is stationary, and also when the both shafts are stationary. So the frictional clutches is largely used because there is wide of applications. These clutches are used when power is to be delivered to machines partially or fully loaded. These clutches are commonly used in automobiles. So today we discuss in friction clutches. The friction clutches work on fact that friction is caused when two rotating discs come in contact with each corner. The clutch should not require any external force to maintain the contact of friction surfaces. The clutch should have provision for carrying away for heat generated during the engagement. It should have provision for facilitating repairs or maintenance. The projecting parts of the clutch should be properly covered by a guard. The coefficient of friction between the contacting surfaces should be sufficiently high and uniform over the surface. In order to minimize the inertia load, the moving parts of the clutch should have low weight. The suitable material forming the contact surface should be selected. The engagement and disengagement should be simple and easy to operate. So, friction clutches largely used. In friction clutches, there are three types: plate or disc clutch, cone clutch, centrifugal clutch. In plate clutch or disc clutch, there is single plate clutch and multiple plate clutches are the type. This is the principle of frictional clutches. Okay, this is in diagram. There is A B C D. So, okay, this is the A B C D shown. Now we discuss about this. What is A? What is A? This is diagram A. C, A, B, C, D, A, C, D, B. This is the engage and disengage position. Now we discuss about all this. Show this figure seriously. Now we discuss about what is A, what is C, what is B, what is D. Let the shaft A and disc C move C be revolving at some speed, say capital N in RPM. Shaft B and disc D key to its stationary initially when the clutch is not engaged. This is the diagram when the clutch is not disengaged. Now apply some axial force W to disc D so that it comes in contact with disc C. As soon as the contact is made, of the force of friction between C and D will come into play, and consequently the disc D will also start revolving. The speed of D depends upon friction force present, which in turn is proportional to the force W applied. If W is increased gradually, the speed of D will be increased correspondingly till the stage comes when the speed of D becomes equal to speed of C. Then clutch is said to be fully engaged. Let capital W is equal to axial load applied, mu is equal to coefficient of friction, capital R is the effective mean radius of friction force, then T is equal to mu WR. This is the dry friction clutches. There are some types of dry friction clutches: single plate clutch, multiple plate clutch, cone clutch, semi-centrifugal clutch, centrifugal clutch. This is the diagram of centrifugal clutch. Okay, in the diagram there is all parts is shown, that is engine shaft, flywheel, clutch pedal, fulcrum pin, bearing, clutch shaft, pressure plate, clutch plate, friction lining, clutch spring. Okay, this is the diagram. Okay, this is a very good diagram. In this there is shown flywheel, friction planes, engine crankshaft, housing to transmission, releasing bearing, pressure plate, pressure spring, clutch plate and driven discs. Okay, this is a diagram of single plate clutch. Okay, now we discuss about design types of single plate clutch. Okay, this is the pressure P on friction plate, this is the R2, this is the radius R1, R2, R, DR, R1, R2, these are the shown in plate clutch. Now we discuss about this design. The total frictional torque, capital T, considering uniform pressure for new bearing, that is equal to 2 by 3, 2, when clutch plate has 2 frictional surface. It is very important. When clutch plate has 2 surfaces, capital T is equal to 2 into 2 by 3 mu cap mu omega R1 cube minus R2 cube upon R1 square minus R2 square. When considering uniform wear for old bearing, T is equal to 2 into 1 by 2 mu omega R1 plus R2. This is the diagram of multiple clutch. Okay, this is the multiple clutch. This is the, in this diagram all points are shown, like engine shaft, pressure plate, fulcrum pin. Okay, this is the diagram of bearing, spring, bearing spring, clutch shaft, friction lining, clutch plate. This is the multiple clutch. This is a multiple plate clutch. This is driver, this is driver. This is pressure plates. Pressure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the friction plates. This is diagram shown for multiple plates. Now we discuss about details in multiple clutch. The multiple plate clutch is an extension of single plate type, where the number of frictional and metal plate is increased. In increase in number of friction surfaces, obviously increases capacity of the clutch to transmit torque. Alternatively, the overall diameter of the clutch is reduced for the same torque transmission as single plate clutch. This type of clutch is therefore used in some heavy transport vehicles and racing cars where high torque is to be transmitted. This finds applications in case of scooters and motorcycles where the space available is limited. When your foot is off the pedal, the spring pulls the pressure plate against the clutch discs, which in turn presses against the flywheel. This locks the engine to the transmission input shaft, causing them to spin at the same speed. The amount of force the clutch can hold depends on the friction between the clutch plate and the flywheel and how much force the spring puts on the pressure plate. When the clutch pedal is pressed, piston pushes on the release fork, which presses the throughout bearing against the middle of the diaphragm spring. As the middle of the diaphragm spring is pushed, in a series of pins near the outside of the spring causes the spring to pull the pressure plate away from the clutch discs. This releases the clutch from the spinning engine. Now, very important parts. Working of single plate clutch. Basically, the clutch needs 3 parts. There are the engine, flywheel, or friction discs called the clutch plate and pressure plate. There are springs which provide axial force to keep the clutch in engaged position. When the engine is running and the flywheel is rotating, the pressure plate also rotates as the pressure plate is attached to the flywheel. The friction disc is located between the two. When the driver has pushed down the clutch pedal, the clutch is released. This action forces and the pressure plate to move away from the friction disc against the force of springs. With this moment of pressure plate, the friction plate is released and the clutch is disengaged. This is the advantages of the single plate clutch. With single plate clutch, gear changing is easier than with the cone clutch because the pedal moment is less in this case. More reliable, it does not suffer from disadvantage of cone clutch, that is binding of cones. So single plate clutch, it is mostly used. So thank you all of you. Today we discuss about in single plate clutch working and advantages and disadvantages. So thank you all of you.